So today we're gonna deconstruct techniques some of the fastest bartenders in the world. When I watched it first time, I couldn't believe how fast the bartender is and how precise. So it looked like they almost flying behind the bar and everything happening in a double speed. If you guys mixing drinks behind a bar, this video will help you become much faster and more efficient bartender. Especially if you work at the nightclub or like maybe service bar where you need to make drinks as fast as possible. And I also wanted to mention that this video is not from new competitions, because these days during speed round, bartenders besides just being super fast and accurate, they also have to engage with guests and basically make it like more realistic, like you work behind the bar. First, always your both hands should be busy. So it's not like you pour with your right hand and left doing nothing. You always have to use your left and right hand. And the hardest part, that it's not just, for example, you do pour with two bottles. The challenge is when you need to learn, for example, when you do pour with your right hand and your left hand already icing up drinks, or if you do pour with your left hand, maybe your right hand, you at the same time closing blender. So this is the biggest challenge, but you always need to use both hands. Second, they're being very, very efficient. Besides both hands, basically, of course, they're trying to use multiple bottles, maybe hold two bottles or two jiggers in one hand. When they go behind the bar, they're thinking already, what else to bring? Not just maybe one bottle, what can I take? Maybe I can take also beer and a bottle. Instead of doing like three trips to your back bar, you basically will be able to do only two. You need to try to be as efficient as possible, and this will save you time. Okay, next, if you notice they're being very fast, but at the same time clean and accurate. So for example, if they have their glassware or shaker on top of the bar, and then when they go back, they take it and bring it really fast, and also bring it back really fast. But when it comes to pour, they make sure that they kind of like slow down a little bit and then do very precise pour, then bring it back really, really fast. But if you're gonna be doing everything with the same speed, that will be a disaster. So you can't just like really bring fast and pour fast at one stop. So you need to like balance, go super fast, slow down, pour, and then bring it back. It's really important to understand, because if you do everything really, really fast without slowing down, there's a big chance you wouldn't pour accurate or make a mess. And next, they actually don't make any mess. So you could see they take bottle from well and it goes in the same place. If they took something from the back bar, it absolutely goes in the same spot. They're not leaving it on top of the bar or not going to well. So everything goes in the same spot. If they use the blender and shaker, they put it together and place it into the sink. So it's very important to keep everything clean and put it back into the same places.
Melon ball, amaretto sour, boo-boo, regular beer, go.
And last thing I wanted to mention, that you need to 100% memorize all the recipes. If you don't remember what goes into this drink or that, you would need to stop, think about it. You will lose a lot of time, and that definitely wouldn't be so fast. Thank you guys for watching this episode. If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing, hit the like button like this, and I will see you next week. Nothing is impossible.